New York City, 1909. Every morning, hundreds of thousands of people poured into Manhattan, headed towards another day's work in the city's 600 garment factories.
Many were young women in their teens, coming from Jewish immigrant families pushed out of Russia, Italy, and Poland. Their families choosing America for a better future. Despite producing $50 million worth of merchandise annually, abysmal working conditions, miserable wages, and gender discrimination dominated the industry. Women worked anywhere from 65 to 75 hours a week. One factory, the Triangle Shirtwaist Company, locked their workers in to prevent them taking breaks. By the fall of 1909, the city was already in the grips of unrest amongst its garment workers, with strikers facing opposition from manufacturers, police, and the courts. On November 22nd, thousands of women packed into Cooper Union for a workers' meeting. But after hours of cautionary talk from the leaders and organizers, 23-year-old Ukrainian immigrant Clara Lemlich Shavelson, a worker at the Triangle Company, demanded the floor and delivered an impassioned speech calling for a general strike that ignited the audience. The following day, 20,000 workers, 70% of them women, took to the streets in an unprecedented strike.
11 weeks of protests ensued and ended in manufacturers meeting the demands for better pay, shorter hours, and equal treatment of union and non-union workers. The uprising of the 20,000, as it later became known as, was an important milestone in the labor rights movement, made only more significant and important by the massive participation and leadership of the women in it.